thank you all for being here. Thank you all for being there every day. Thank you all for being at my side with our family, fighting for the right things for Louisiana. I just called Congressman Cassidy to congratulate him after a long and tough campaign. I told him that representing the people of this state is the greatest honor that anyone could ever have. The people of our state, the people of our state have spoken. And while we were working and hoping and praying for a different outcome, I'm so proud that our campaign was open and accessible to the voters, debating where we could, talking about issues that are important to the people of Louisiana. Because where I come from, and you can tell a little bit with this family, there is no quit. So we were excited to work hard. I could never, ever have started this race or finished it if it wasn't for a solid and secure faith in God Himself. And without my family, my extraordinary husband Frank, who has not only been with me every step of the way, but encouraged me and actually egged me on every step of the way. Our beautiful daughter, Mary Shannon, and our wonderful son and daughter-in-law, Emily, and the most precious angel of all, Maddox Parker Snelling. Oh, you should never put a precious child on the stage with you. They'll upstage you every time, and he has. To my mother and father, who taught me so much about two of the most extraordinary leaders this country has ever known, Moon and Verna Landrieu. To all of my brothers and sisters, all eight siblings, their husbands, and wives, and our nieces, nephews, and friends, God bless you all that were out on the street until 8 o'clock tonight. There are literally hundreds of staffers, but no staffer has been at my side longer and in more of the toughest moments and the most joyful moments than Norma Jane Sabiston. Norma Jane! Get up here, Norma Jane. We met when we were 17 years old, and she hasn't stopped bossing me around since, all right? And to my current chief of staff, a wonderful, promising young leader, Don Cravens. And when our campaign needed a new direction, we reached over and stole one of the best, or borrowed, one of the best staffers from Mitch Landrieu, Ryan Burney. Where are you, Mr. Ryan Burney? Ryan! So, I want to thank all staffers, literally over 100, but also to the Louisiana Democratic Party that never left our side. Karen Carter Peterson, what an amazing young woman. And to Congressman Richmond, who has been with us, and congratulations, of course, to him, who won in the primary, to Congressman Richmond and the entire leadership. Now, we've got some elected officials that are on this stage tonight. There are too many to mention, but I can promise you there is a deep and extraordinary bench of young Democratic leaders in this state ready to lead and ready to carry on. Just briefly, on a very sad note, if I could have just a moment, we had over 3,000 people out working today, and like we've been working every day for 18 months. And a young woman that had just started working with us, but her older sister works with the mayor of Shreveport, was fatally struck by an automobile while she was canvassing today. So we want to acknowledge her and her family tonight, and we've all been saddened, our hearts are broken, and her family, of course, is in mourning, but Karen Carter is with them tonight. Let me briefly say that it has been nothing but a joy to serve this state for over 34 years. When my amazing father ran for mayor, and even prior to that, 44 years ago, he put a great coalition of progressive men and women together from all walks of life, from different racial backgrounds. He fought for openness and opportunity and freedom for all and access to the middle class and security and justice and fairness. We have together built that same coalition, and it is obvious in this room tonight. We have always known what we were fighting for, a stronger state, a state more committed to justice, openness, and opportunity, regardless of where you were born, what zip code you were born into, or the color of your skin. We may not have won tonight, but we most certainly have won some extraordinary victories. We have stood shoulder to shoulder to secure our coast, to find for the first time in our state's history a robust stream of revenue that will come into this state long after we're gone, $250 million a year. To not only protect our great industries, but also our unique and amazing culture that is so worth preserving and so worth fighting for. And that was a tough fight. Some people thought it was impossible, and many people tried. But the group in this room, my supporters, all of you, and our staff made that happen. We have three major military bases in Louisiana: Barksdale Air Force Base, Fort Polk, one of the greatest training centers for our men and women in uniform anywhere in the world, and Belchase, right here in this region. We have made them stronger, we have built them better, and they are flourishing because of our commitment. The work that many of us have done for orphans in America, all over the world, strengthening our foster care system, and saying clearly that every child deserves a forever family and a place to call home. Together, we have also fought a good fight, and it's not over yet, for health care. Because to have a... To have a strong workforce, to lift our state and move it forward and to lift our nation forward, we have to have a healthy workforce. We have to have a way for people, no matter where they work or how they work, to be able to have an access to doctors, to nurses, to people that can keep them healthy. They can have security when they sleep at night, knowing their children can have access. And if they get stricken with cancer or heart disease or diabetes, they can't be thrown off the insurance rolls anymore. This is something to be proud of, and I'm glad we fought for it. We are in a hotel tonight that is named after one of the great leaders of our country, a great name, the Roosevelts. And you all, I hope you saw that recent story of their life and their contribution. One of my very favorite quotes from Teddy Roosevelt is the quote about the critic. It is not the critic who counts. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by the dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs and comes up short. But because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who does actually strive to do the deeds, who spends himself in a worthy cause. And in the end, he knows high achievement, and who at worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who know neither defeat or victory. For 34 years, we've fought for some amazing things. And tonight, honestly, I can tell you all, it has been a joy. It has been the joy is in the journey, and the satisfaction and reward is in the fight. If you want to spend your life in a worthy cause, choose something that takes longer than your life to achieve, and then you know it's worth fighting for. So when I look at my young children, when I look at my grandson, when I look at the young staffers that are out here, and I've seen you work like I have out in the fields and on the streets and on the farms and the big cities and the little towns, talking with voters, but more than that, listening to the voters about their hopes, their aspirations. It has been a great privilege to be able to represent them, to fight for them in Washington. Tonight, we have so much to be proud of, a record of courage, honesty, and integrity, and delivering for this state when it mattered the most in some of our darkest hours after Katrina, Rita, Gustav, Ike, and the BP oil spill. So the joy has been in the fight. It's been a blessing. It's been a fight worth waging. Louisiana will always be worth fighting for. May God always bless us, bless our nation. We thank God for the democracy that we have, for the right of people to vote. We honor and accept the decision tonight, but I cannot tell you all and my family how proud we are to have made a big difference every day for many decades, and we will continue to do so. Thank you so much.